Hey people, thanks for watching this video. I just wanted to share with you something that's in my own thoughts really. This didn't come through a vision or any sort of revelation that's come to me. It's just through my general thought of so many pieces of a puzzle fitting together and having an idea of a possible warning sign of the rapture to come. I want to break this down into pieces so that I try and get across the point I'm trying to make without confusing too many people. I just want to show you, a lot of Christians obviously probably won't be too bothered about astronomy, but this is Planet X, it's Nibiru. And basically it is its own constellation. I'll explain it to you as like an astronomer would. It's got its own small red sun in the middle of it, and around this sun you've got all these meteoroids, and then still around that you've got this big red dust particle, whatever it might be, some saying iron oxide, but I just want you to picture the vision. You've got a small red sun type object, and then you've got lots of meteoroids around that, and then around that again in a bigger like teardrop shape you've got this big red iron oxide dust cloud, and then around that still you've got seven planets and possibly its own Earth. I'll just play this video now.
Afraid to talk about it. It was in the science magazines. I mean, I had a subscription to like Popular Science, and hell, it was on the front cover of the magazine one day in like 1960. This baby's out there in the sky. There's,
here you can see.
It's just right here. There's nothing to worry about it.
There you can see a better picture, and you see the red, all the. You know, that's obviously atmosphere, but you can see how red the sky is, and that thing isn't even close. I have a funny feeling that this red planet, let's say for now, might eclipse with the sun as it comes up. So you imagine how big it is when it eclipses the sun.
It won't be here for another 50 years. Hey, guess what? That 50 years has came and gone. And this baby's out there in the sky. They've been watching it. I watched it. And I can tell you, this thing has got so much trash coming around it. You know how we live in a solar system? We've got 9 planets and a big sun. This thing has got 7 planets and its own sun. But I believe that instead of having dirt on it, like our planet does, and water, I think this thing is just a big, bright reddish-orange iron ball because it's giving off all this red iron oxide dust out into the atmosphere. When we thought at first it was just a teeny little red speck of fuzzy red dust in the distance, but over the years as it went by and we watched it, it got bigger and bigger and bigger. And then finally, about 08, we could see this thing like it was across the street. And we could see that it was a blazing hot ball of fire giving out sparkles of red iron oxide dust for thousands of miles in every direction. And you could see the planets circulating it. Now, I'll tell you one thing that I really am nervous about. I think this thing's got a planet like ours circling it. This is its own solar system. We're about to have a solar system come through the middle of our solar system.
Now if you want to watch the whole video, you can go onto my videos and go to the NASA employee speaks about Planet X, Nibiru. But what you need to realise is that the government have been watching this, and NASA have sent a plane equipped with a telescope to like New Zealand, Australia, way as south as they can go, and they've been flying up as high as they can go, and then they've been seeing as far as they can to try and see something. Now obviously it's not Comet Ison, because Comet Ison's on its way and they're tracking it and they've told everyone about it. No one speaks about Nibiru. But I just want to flip now to Revelation. and more importantly, the opening of the sixth seal. So when the opening of the sixth seal comes, I looked and behold, and there was a great earthquake, and the sun became black as sackcloth, and the full moon became like blood. Well, in this video of NASA, the effects of this Nibiru planet coming at us, this star, this red star, will be massive earthquakes, because it will grab hold of the Earth. I'll just read on now. And the stars of the sky fell to the Earth like a fig tree in the winter. Now I see these stars as, well, obviously stars of the sky are like angels of the sky. So the angels of the heavens will fall to the ground. The sky will vanish up like a scroll that has been rolled up. Well, that's understandable if you've got something with the power, magnetic power of this thing coming right and locking onto the Earth. And then every mountain and island was removed from its place. And with that, it means that the pole shift, the crust, every mountain and island is going to move as this red planet, let's call it for now, drags it round. The crust is just going to be going like that. It's going to be a huge earthquake. And then here's the best bit. And then the kings of the earth and the great ones and the generals and the rich and the powerful and everyone and slave free hid themselves in the caves of the rocks of the mountains. Now, here we go. Here's a poll. Here's a pole shift video. Chile has been removed from its axis, or so they say. And so is Japan, if you do your research.
A professor of earth sciences at England's Liverpool University. He's analyzed the area. Powerful, it shifted the Earth's axis. That's what scientists say.
So this earthquake that's happened is going to shift the whole world, its axis. It's going to be pole shift. And all the generals and the rich will run to their caves.
And drives inside. I make sure we've got cameras rolling. This place isn't only the largest underground facility in the area, they say it's the largest in the world. Look at this. They got room for two lanes of 18-wheelers. The road literally goes on for miles. Look, there, it's branching off again. Who knows where that leads? Maybe even to the Huff House.
Do you think they're watching us right now?
Yeah.
And this thing's hooked up to railroad, too.
This facility covers 50 million.
So when the rich and the powerful run to their caves, they'll be running to their underground cities, which they've been building for God knows how long, probably 50 years at least. And now I want to draw you to the next section, is the sealing of the 144,000 saints. So after this, I saw four angels standing in the four corners of the earth, holding back the four winds of the earth, and no might blow on the earth or the sea against any tree. Then I saw another angel ascending from the rising of the sun with the seal of the living God, and he called out loud to the four angels who had been given power to hurt the earth, saying, "Do not harm the earth or the sea or the trees until we have sealed our servants of our God on their foreheads." And 144,000 saints, tribulation saints, were sealed. But after this, a great multitude of people appear in heaven. Rapture time. Rapture time. Now, the third part of it is, after all that happens, so after the four angels and the four corners of the earth, and after the angel with the seal of the living God seal his servants, and after a great multitude of saved people appear in heaven, the seven angels with the seven trumpets are about to sound. Now, the first angel, before all this, an angel takes fire from the altar and casts it to the earth, and peals of thunder and rumblings and flashings of lightning and an earthquake. So that'll probably be worldwide, that. And then, is the most fitting one to what I'm trying to get at here. The first angel blew his trumpet, and there followed hail and fire mixed with blood, and these were thrown upon the earth, and a third of the earth was burned up, and a third of the trees were burned up. So the first angel will be meteoroids mixed with blood rain. Now these are all possible, blood rain. If you look at my trumpets video, you'll see that's been proven, the actual live living type of blood is possible as falling down as rain. So with all that in mind, if you look back at Nibiru and what it actually is,
I'm watching it. I watch it. Am I? It says right here. There's nothing to worry about.
So if you actually look what Nibiru is, and by the way, you'll have to look at the full NASA video, but when this Nibiru comes into closer contact with the our solar system, it's a dust cloud that follows it starts to look a bit like wings. Does that not sound interesting? I seen another mighty angel rising up from ascending from the rising of the sun. Does that not sound like Nibiru? The four angels standing at the four corners of the earth. Does that not sound like its moons? And after that, trumpet number one, meteoroids falling from this thing. Does that not sound like Nibiru? Blood. Does that not sound like the red dust cloud that's surrounding Nibiru? You know, I just wanted to throw this out as an idea, but I think this might be a warning sign that we might see a red sky or a red atmosphere before this thing and the rapture turns up. And one other thing I want to try and do very quickly, you see this, lots of people have been having visions about when the missiles come down, we go up in a rapture. When the missiles come down, we go up in a rapture. Now, let's say this red atmosphere does happen. Have you ever? Yeah? And who will be dropping missiles? Have you ever seen a little film about North Korea overtaking America and missiles come down in the morning? Do you know what the name of that film was called? Red Dawn. Not red sun, not red moon, red dawn, red sky in the morning. I personally think that the sky is going to go red days before the rapture. So it'd just be another thing to look at. If you haven't been saved, get saved now. Admit your sins to God the Father. I have sinned. Forgive me of my sins. I have forgiven other people for their sins. In the precious name of Yeshua HaMashiach, Jesus Christ, the Lord and Savior. Amen.